Well, what was your preparation like coming into this game?
We talked a lot about what we did, what we didn't do very well against City the other day. No matter when, no matter what, it's a rivalry and it is going to be a tough game. They're going to play hard, we're going to play hard, and it's no preparation for it. Tuesday, there was no preparation for Tuesday. You can scout a kid, you can scout a couple kids, you can say what they do as a team, but it's really no preparation for it because it's that fire in your belly when you got a Poly City game.
The kids feel that, you think?
I do.
Did you go to
class in 96?
Did you go to New York? Did you play?
Yes, sir.
She even knows every score. Yeah. You know?
So that's the maturity.
Poly City thing is still going on pretty strong.
Yeah.
That's great. I'm glad they did.
Yes. No more than two. We just added girls.
Okay. Well, I understand.
We just played them. I coach volleyball too. We just played them for the city championship for volleyball too.
Oh, you did? Did you beat them?
It was a tough one then too.
I'm sure. Yeah, they're tough. Their guards are great. But so are you. So what do you do to slow them down? What did you do? They seemed to be off their game.
We went to a man-to-man kind of sort of with certain things. We kind of switched the defense up. We got to make them think. If they can just be fast, they'll be fast. But if you make them uncomfortable, they got to make some decisions. So we changed the defense up a lot.
What about the balance that you guys, you know, have with your inside outside? It's, right now, this is something that's really a real weakness.
Just want to. Mm-hmm. It's not even really. We can teach somebody a move on Monday, and they've got it by Friday or Thursday. I mean, not perfect, but they've got it well enough. Sometimes you can go a season teaching a kid how to do something, and they won't do it in a game. They'll do it in a practice, but won't do it in a game. Like, I have kids who have the ball enough to try it because they trust. And in the same token, we trust them.
So these kids are good learners?
Yes. They want to learn. And when you talk about it from a perspective of, okay, you won, but this is what we need to tweak, they're right. Sometimes the hardest thing to do is keep a team that's undefeated engaged because they don't feel like they have to do anything to improve. My current seniors were undefeated their sophomore year. And it was hard. It was hard to make simulations in practice. It was hard to simulate a lot of different things. But I think when you have somebody's attention, I can tell them anything.
So are you guys undefeated now?
Yeah, we have one loss to Bethlehem Catholic in a holiday tournament. But as far as we're concerned with the region, we don't have any losses.
Just talk about turning your attention.
We played a big team. We played Roland Park Country, who gave us a serious go.
That was a great game.
Bethlehem Catholic was tough, but it was we did poorly defensively in the first quarter and never recovered from that. But Milford, we played like we've got our bumps.
Let's talk about your defense tonight. We made a lot. Transition.
Right. We trusted to contain. We didn't gamble. We trusted one another. We played together. When we didn't like what someone else did, we addressed it.
Think you guys are playing your best basketball right now?
No. I'm sorry. The Dunbar game was amazing to watch. I've seen them do stuff in the Dunbar game. I think we're playing balanced. But the Dunbar game was amazing.
You had 40 points at halftime.
Unreal.
I know. If you could have matched that, what's your high point total?
My highest point total, I think we scored 8 points.
You did? Okay.
Yeah, but these are kids.
So you're halfway there. It's a great team.
These are kids that would never score more than 60 points. They would tell you, no matter what the contest, we'll play good defense, but there's no scoring.
So,
I'm sorry, I'm just I'm not ignoring you. I'm just telling you about the game. My kids are
in your region, who's going to be second seed in your region?
City should be.
It'll be City.
It may be. The only losses they have are to us, I think.
I see.
Yeah, as far as the seeding is concerned, I don't even think
they lost to Patterson Mill. I think that was a regular season.
Yes.
You know what they say about beating a team a third time?
You know what they say about beating them twice?
Yeah.
So it's going to be harder, and I keep saying, we did it for right now, but this is the bragging rights game. Next week or 2 weeks from now, those are the games that really, really matter. You know, we didn't make it here last year because we lost to them. We led the entire game. We lost to them, I want to say, by 7, by the, you know, the turn of the table. But, you know, we made it to the state championship game. So we could bypass the bragging rights game and get to the business. Not that this wasn't important, and we don't need it to stroke our ego a little bit, but we want next week.
So this is the bragging rights game.
Yeah.
Next week is the...
Yeah, this wouldn't put me out of anything if I just lost this game. Yeah. I got some seniors who don't want it to end, who are looking for college opportunities, and I want our coach as long as they want to play.
Thank you.